Okay, we're going to look at number 12 in section 2.6. We're going to evaluate the following limit. There's a lot of these type problems in section 2.6. So limit as h goes to 0 of sine of 8h over h. Okay, well, again, for any function, if I'm taking the limit, if it's continuous, you know, I'm taking the limit as h approaches 0. If it's continuous at 0, then I can just plug in and evaluate it. Problem is, if I plug in 0, I get sine of 0, which is 0 over 0. That's not a real number. And of course, that's the indeterminate form, meaning this limit doesn't mean the limit doesn't exist. It means we've got some work to do. Now, when we have limits of this type involving trig functions, we have this important limit. There's actually two important limits. These are actually given on the trigonometry help sheet that I give you on the test, where you have the fundamental identities, right triangle definitions, unit circle, and then you'll see those two limits right there. And this is the one we're going to use. I proved both of these in lecture, but this is the one we're going to use now. Okay, so is this limit in the same form? Well, I've got sine of 8h over h. It's not sine of theta over theta. I would need the same thing that I'm taking the sine of. Now, this 8 cannot be pulled out. This is not sine times h. This is sine of 8h. It's not multiplication going on here. So this 8 cannot come out. But I can make, since this is 8h in here, I can make this an 8h by multiplying top and bottom by 8. And this 8 will go with this h, right, to give me 8h. This 8 I'll pull outside the limit, which I can do provided this resulting limit exists. And this limit exists. Now you'll notice the original is the limit as theta goes to 0, sine of theta over theta. This is h goes to 0, sine of 8h over 8h. Well, as h goes to 0, 8h goes to 0, and sort of formally show that I can let theta be 8h, right? And so as h goes to 0, then theta is going to 0. And so this limit becomes 8 times the limit of theta going to 0 and just replacing 8h with theta, sine theta over theta. And this, right, is equal to 1, 8 times 1 being 8. And so the limit is 8. Okay, so this is very simple, but students do have a little trouble with these type of limits. Again, if you have questions about them, please let me know.